compressed for all, you know, I'm sure all the women can understand the idea of the compression strain. It's not fun. And I have to kind of go, well, I understand, like, is that how it looks? That kind of thing. But anyway, so I see little snippets and the show looks good and I feel good about, you know, good enough about what I see, and I just hope I can get feedback from the producers and what the network is going to say they like about it, and it feels good. We have fun on set. So I'm excited to see them. I actually think I'm gonna watch them. I haven't watched that many of them. Because we're so busy doing it for 15 hours a day, it's hard to go home and then watch it. That's horrible. I seem like so, like, just, you're just not happy about being here. You've been waiting forever. Just, yeah, I just gonna say that. No, so better. The nine episodes that I've already shot, I have no idea. I can't remember. A lot of things. Foster gets a love interest. An actor named Max Martini plays Burns, who shows up, and it's sort of fun to see what happens to Lightman when I have a love interest. And a lot of exciting stuff happens there, and then, I shouldn't, do I say, can I say? I never know what I can say.
Spoiler away.
Right? He, is not who he says he is, so, like, I clearly pick well in terms of people that I date on the show, and he gets into a mess of trouble, and we have to help him get out of it, and it's, you know, kind of sad for Foster in the end, but then she has Cal. At the end, why dysfunction? I think that it's more interesting to play, certainly as an actor, when people make mistakes and they're fallible. I think that one of the things in the true science of it, and we all know this obviously, is that in our own lives, it's hard to see what we're in and what we're. It's easy to miss a lot when you're emotionally invested. You don't want to see the person that you care about so much. You know, behave in a certain way, or you tolerate it in a different way than you would for a friend who's going through the very same thing, and you go, what the hell? Like, can you see? Like, it's not right for you, or whatever, all the different details. I'm sure that Foster sees her own shrink, even though she is a shrink. You know, it's not a surprise. She's married to her work a lot of times. She also, in the way that it works with serious television, is that all of a sudden you'll just read a script for the actor, and like in 2 days, you have this whole story, this whole life that you've supposedly had for a while, like this new person you're dating, and you had no idea about it 2 days ago, so you kind of wonder, you have to inject all sorts of subtext into something that you've just been introduced to, and then you'll cut to the next episode, you see them, and it's like we've been together for months, and then you have to, you know, constantly having to shift those things, and so we just hope that it works at the end of the day, I guess. We'll get a shorthand as actors together doing scenes, and then we also have a shorthand with the characters, which is fun as if the show gets a chance to kind of find its legs and get, you know, if we get to make more and more episodes. We sort of really know how our characters would respond, and it sort of is parallel to, you know, us. And we're still, you know, we have a good system. It's like we spend so much time together, but we, you know, are a fun laugh, you know, give each other space, do all the things that you would. It's sort of like a, you know, he's my work husband, you know what I mean, that kind of thing. But they haven't completely explored their friendship, their relationship within the show as much. Though there is, in one of those nine episodes, there's a storyline that was really so much fun to do, which does a flashback to my time at the Pentagon when I meet Cal. So that you actually show, they showed some of the sessions, or sessions, I had all this hair too, it was fantastic. And it was fun to do because then it created, you know, a real, not just the subtext that we created, but the real text of what has happened and how we've carried that with us all these years and the lies, or are they lies, that we've carried and how our relationship has developed. And it was challenging because we wanted to get it right. It's a hard thing. Flashbacks, I think, are always really tricky. You know, kind of like a montage, you always think like you can kill it, or that can also really inform it and give it a lot more life, and I hope that it gives it a relationship a lot more life.
Yeah.
kids to school. Yes. Because my mom, so, and I hopefully we'll be able to travel a little bit. My husband's doing a pilot for Fox as well right now. So he and I are both in the same, you know, waiting game a little bit for the upfronts to see if both our shows get picked up. And so we're sort of, we have ideas. We have the trip if we have a show that gets picked up. We have the small trip if it doesn't. We have the saving money type of thing that, like, we go for a couple days someplace. So we have a whole different itinerary. You know, my plans. I didn't want to work unless there was something that I really liked, because it's a 10-month year. It's a pretty intense year. So it'd be nice to just hang out and be home. Yes. That was luckily just a day of work, a very long day into the morning of work. It was a lot of fun. It was a camera rig to a taxi that was barely staying on, falling off. It's like that great thing I'm doing, really truly independent filmmaking, where, you know, people kept asking us directions. We weren't really a real cab. They thought we were taxi cab confessions. But it was fun. I was booked, incredibly strung out, and a bit junkie, and it was a lot of fun to do. And that film went to Tribeca. It's one of my dearest, oldest friends. Directed and wrote it, and he quit the business and became pilot for 7 years, and then decided that he was done with that, and he wrote a script. It happens on the day 9/11, where the plane gets grounded, and Melissa Leo plays the lead. It's a really great story, so we're excited for him that he got it. Tell me again. No, that's somebody else. Is it? All right. No, my part's really small. I'm in there for a second. I'm the junkie that creates a lot of havoc and then changes the course of this kid's life.
Deception, the concept of deception. And you know, like the show where you see, like, it's in space.
Because of the show. I'd like to think that doing this in the research, though I didn't do a ton. I mean, Dr. Anton was here a lot to answer a lot of questions. But I mean, I've always been interested in people and behavior, and as an actor, I think that it's, you know, not like I'm a weirdo where I have to watch people, but I find it very interesting what we do, our quirks. So I've always been interested in how people lie or how people are. I know a little more, I think, than I used to, which kind of freaks me out sometimes, because I'll get a glimpse of, especially people that I don't know more often than not, but I don't know, I'm no expert. But I think that it's weird, this whole tabloid world of television and being aware of people's personal lives so much more than we ever used to. It